بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين سيدنا وحبيبنا مولانا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى آله وأصحابه وبارك وسلم. سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا، اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وزدنا علما، يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك، آمين. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. كيف حالكم؟ الحمد لله. بسم الله. الحمد لله. We are now at the end of the third term, inshallah. Next week we're off, and then after that, inshallah, we begin the fourth term. And as we're ending the third term, we're also ending the Nahu syllabus, inshallah. So let's start with some revision. We learned how many jumlas, how many sentences? Two sentences. What are they called? Jumlatul ismiya and jumlatul fi'liya. Then we learned how many murakkabs? Four. Give me the names of them. Masuf and sifa, good. Okay, mudaf, mudaf nilay. حرف الجر اسم مجرور and last six one اسم الإشارة إلي. Okay, so before we continue, inshallah, I want you to find two or three people around you, inshallah. Just move together. Find two or three people around you, inshallah. Eh? Yeah, but I see now it's long weekend. Okay. Okay, so if you look at the screen quickly, how many parts does Jumlatul Fi'liya have? Jumlatul Fi'liya. Like Nasara, Arajulu, Al-Walada, how many parts does that have? Three. What are the three parts? The fi'l, the verb. Fa'il, maf'ulun bihi. Good. And then Jumlatul Ismiya, how many parts does that have? Which are? Mubtada and Khabar. So I want you to take out the sheet of paper, inshallah, a blank sheet of paper. Let's make it five columns, inshallah. So in other words, five columns. Column number one, I want you to label it Raf'un. Next one, Nasbun. Next one is Jarrun. Next one is going to be a follower. Follower, and next one's going to be, let's call it next one's going to be, what's going to call the next one? No specific hal. Okay, Raf'un, Nasbun, Jarrun, and then no specific hal. Okay, with me. So Raf'un is the first one. Oh, is it a bit small then? Is it a bit bigger? Yeah? Raf'un is the first one. Then Nasbun. Then Jarrun. Then next one is follower. And the next one is no specific hal. Okay. Then what I want you to do next. Okay, the other. What I want you to do next is that you've done two jumlas and four murakkabs. Two jumlas and four murakkabs. I want you to plot each element somewhere under that table. Somewhere under the table. I'll do one example for you so you can just see how it works each other. For example, say I'm doing mudaf and mudafun ilay. What components are there? There's two. There's a mudaf and there's a mudafun ilay. Okay, let's do the easy one first. Which one will I put mudafun ilay under? Is it raf'un, nasbun, jarun, nufallawa, or no specific hal? Mudafun ilay. Remember Dafna Lay? Baytul Waladi. Rasulullahi. Okay, let me maybe add another word maybe to make it easier for you, in case you can be confused. This here is going to read always Rafun. This one here is going. What's happening? My is your battery in here? Always, this is always Nasbun. Oops. Always Nasbun. So just back to my question again. Back to my question again. When I come to Mudaf and Mudafun Ilay, for Mudafun Ilay, which column will it be? And it's going to be a always jarun. So what I'm saying is actually you can do for each, or you can do for jumla fi'liya, jumla ismiya, sifa mawsuf, harf jar, ism majrur, mudaf, mudaf ilay, and each one. I'm the one for you. So mudaf ilay, in other words, mudaf ilay will go under this column here. It's a what one? It's a always jar. Remember mudaf ilay is always. Always jar. Are you with me? Mudafun ilayhi is always jar. Do you all agree with me? Okay. Mudafun ilayhi is always jar. So we do like that. What's the other component of mudafun, mudafun ilayhi? Mudaf. So which column is mudafun in? So it's always raf'un, a mudaf. Always nasbun, no. Always jarun, is the follower. Does it follow something? No. So in other words, it's no specific hal. In other words, mudaf depends on the context. No specific hal, in other words, depends on context. So here, let me just put now another thing here. It's here. Depends on context. On context, the hal other on context. So in other words, mudaf will go here. Mudafun. Mudafun will go here. Are you with me? Okay, so I want you to do the same thing for the two jumlas and each murakkab. Okay, just plot where it goes. So jumla fi'liya, fa'il, maf'ul, mubtada, khabar. Each one, just plot it where it goes. Okay, in your groups inshallah, in your groups, bismillah. Plot where it goes. If you're stuck inshallah, confused, you can raise your hand, we'll come around to assist inshallah. Let's go through the answers. What you should have more or less on your sheet, inshallah. So we will start. If you all face the screen, we'll just check it, inshallah. So basically, we try to take all the work that you did the whole year and putting it on this table, inshallah. So the first thing you did was, after gender obviously, but the first thing you did was Jumlatul Fi'liya. Al Jumlatul Fi'liya. So Jumlatul Fi'liya has how many parts? Three parts: the fi'l, which is the verb, the fa'il, and the maf'ulun bihi. So when you leave fi'l off the table, because this table only doesn't deal with any verbs, so we're leaving fi'l off. So there's two things you have to plot: fa'ilun and maf'ulun bihi. Fa'ilun and maf'ulun bihi. Where do we plot the fa'il? The fa'il is what? Always in raf'un. So you should have there, fa'ilun should always be in raf'un. Fa'ilun. Then, what is maf'ulun bihi always in? The maf'ulun bihi is always in nas. So you should have here, maf'ulun bihi. Okay. Maf'ulun bihi. That's the first thing. So hopefully all of that. Jumlatul fi'liya. The fa'il, the doer, the subject will always be in raf'un. Whether it's on the end or left or inside, doesn't matter where it is, it's always in raf'un. Whether you can see the raf' or you can't see the raf', doesn't matter, it's always in raf'un. The maf'ulun bihi will always be in nasbun. Always be in nasbun. Okay, what's the next thing after jumlatul fi'liya is what? Jumlatul ismiya. Al-waladu tawilun. The boy is tall. Al-baytu kabirun. The house is big. Good. So now, what are the two parts of Jumlatul Ismiya? The Mubtada and the Khabar. Mubtada is the focus of the sentence, and the Khabar is giving you news about the focus. Something is something. So where is Mubtada going to feature? The Mubtada is always in Raf'un. Okay, the Mubtada is always in Raf'un. Always in Raf'un, the Mubtada. And the news, the khabar is always in what? The khabar is also always in Raf'un. So the khabar is always in Raf'un. You all with me so far? All agree? Okay. Now we come to our four murakkabs. What is the first murakkab that we did? Mawsuf and Sifa. Mawsuf is the thing, entity being described, and Sifa is the adjective description. The thing being described, Al-Baytu, Al-Kabiru, is the Sifa. Let's do the Sifa first. Not the Mawsuf, the Sifa, the describing word, the adjective. What is the adjective there? It can be any ha, but of those two, I'm going to say it's a follower. Why it's a follower? Because if it's al-baytu, it will follow it and say al-kabiru. If it's al-bayta, it will follow and say al-kabira. If it's al-bayti, it will follow and say al-kabiri. Al-kabiri. So there we're going to have as a follower, let me just rather put it, okay, put it on top, is fine. We're going to have the, or I'll put it in the same row rather. We're going to have mawsuf. Not Mawsuf, sorry, Sifa. Sifa. So Sifa, in other words, when I say a follower, it will always follow the one before it. Okay? It will always follow the hal of the Mawsuf. That's how you determine that. How do you know the hal of the Sifa? You look at the hal of the Mawsuf. And it will always follow the hal of the Mawsuf. How about the Mawsuf? Okay, so when I say Mawsuf, is it always in the Raf'un? No, it could be Al-Bayta Al-Kabira. Always in Nasbun? No, it could be Al-Bayti Al-Kabiri. Always Jarun? No, it could be Al-Baytu Al-Kabiru. Is the Mawsuf following anything? No, it's not a follow, it's a thing being followed. So in other words, the Mawsuf doesn't have a specific hal on its own. It needs something else to make its hal. For example, I might have Ila, and the Ila will make the Mawsuf Ila Al-Bayti Al-Kabiri. Can see, but Mawsuf on its own can't give you a hal. It's something else has to make the hal. Okay, so Mawsuf doesn't give you a specific hal, it needs some other context to give you the hal. Okay, what is the next one? But first, Harful Jar and Ismul majrur. So a harful jar is a harf. So a harful jar doesn't even have a hal. So you can even not put it on the list also. Because it doesn't depend on the context. A harful jar never has a hal in any context. Fi is just fi without a hal. Okay. So I'm going to leave harful jar off the list. Well, I'll make another column there, the no hal column. You understand? Because it doesn't ever have a hal. You with me? What about ism majrur? Where does it feature? It's always in jar. Good. So ism al majrur is always in jar. Let's make this easier for you to read. Ism al majrur is always in jar. Okay. So half of jar doesn't even feature there. It's on the no hal column. Good. What's the next one you did? Mudaf and mudafun ilay, which I gave you the answer at the beginning of the period. Let's do it again, inshallah. Let's do the mudafun ilay. Where does the mudafun ilay feature? The mudafun ilay. Baytul waladi. The house of the boy. Rasulullah, the messenger of Allah. The second word is mudafun ilay. What's mudafun ilay always? Jar. Remember, because mudafun ilay is what? Always light followed by jar. The second thing is jar. It's always mudafun ilay. If it's mudafun ilay, it has to be jar. So mudafun ilay is always in jar. So mudafun ilayhi features there. How about the mudaf? No specific hal. No, I can say baytullahi, baytallahi, baytillahi, depending on the context. You know, so mudaf on its own doesn't give you a hal. It depends what comes before the mudaf, how the mudaf is impacted. Okay, so the mudaf doesn't have a specific hal. Last one. What's the last one? Ismul ishara and musharun ilay. Okay. Let's do, for example, ismul ishara. What's a musharun ilay again? Okay, but what is a musharun ilay? Now the ismul ishara is a pointing. What's a musharun ilay? Hadhal baytu. Dhalikal waladu. What's a musharun ilay? I'm saying, what, like, if someone asks you, what's a musharun ilay, what are you going to say? If someone asks you, what's a ismul ishara, you're going to say it's a demonstrative pronoun, like this, that, these, hadha, hadhi, dhalika, tilka, haulai, ulaika. If someone asks you, what's a musharun ilay, what are you going to say? Okay, it's the ism that comes after the ismul ishara, but I'm looking for it must have an al. Remember the discussion last week? Hadhal baytu, hadha al baytu. If it has an al, we call it musharun ilay. If there's no al, we don't call it musharun ilay. Does that sound vaguely familiar? A little bit, been a week, but vaguely familiar. Is that if the word after the ismul ishara, if it has an al, only then do I call it ismul, I'm sorry, musharun ilay. If it doesn't have an al, it's actually mubtada and khabar. Okay. Anyway. So that second word musharun ilay, what can you tell me, which column does it fall under? It's a follower. It will always follow the hal of the ismul ishara. So it's going to be a musharun ilayhi. The musharun ilayhi is going to be a follower. How about the ismul ishara? Like the hadha, hadhihi, dhalika, tilka, haulai, ulaika. Again, it depends on the context. I can say fi hadha albayt. Then the hadha is a ismul majrur. If I can say ra'aytu hadha albayta, then the hadha is going to be a maf'ulun bihi. I saw this house. هذا البيت كبير. هذا مبتدا. So depends on the context. It depends on the context. اسم الإشارة depends on the context. So if you sort of vaguely understand what's going on the screen, then you sort of vaguely know what you did for the year. Like, if that makes some sort of sense to you in your mind, then that helps you to understand where we are. Okay, because remember we said at the beginning of the year is that there's only fi'lu ismun fi'lun harfun. When it comes to ism, they always what? Raf'un, nasbun, jarrun. That's it. So all we do is we just plot all the raf'un, nasbun, jarrun. So in other words, how many raf'un things did you do? Three. You did fa'il, mubtada, khabar. So you did three raf'un things. In Arabic, there are six. So you must just do three more. Okay, then you finish the raf'un. Next day, inshallah, we do the other three. How many nasbun things did you do? One. In Arabic, there are 11. So just 10 left, inshallah. But the 10 are easy 10, no, it isn't difficult 10. The 10 are easy. We do it next day, inshallah. And in how many jarun things did you do? Two. In Arabic, there's only two. So you finished. So you finished the jarun column. There's no more to add. How many followers did you do? Two. In Arabic, there's only four. Do you understand? So we're done. So I'm done. I'm saying there's a map. And once you finish the map and you fill the rest of this table, then your Arabic is finished. There's no more stuff to learn. There's obviously like deeper, intricate knowledge of each one that is doesn't end. But I'm saying the basic framework is done. When you've done six raf'un things, 11 nasbun things, two jarun things, and four followers, you've finished Arabic grammar, the essentials of it. There's no more new titles to add, really. It's always small things, but not fundamental things. So in first year, we finish here. With how many things? Three raf'un things, one nasbun things, two jarun things, and two followers. Okay, that's your first year syllabus. Your job for now is to see these things in the text. So I ask all the teachers to highlight this when you're even doing Quran and Quran as well. So before the teacher comes to, like Imam Zakaria is doing, Surah Mulk with you, before you come to class, try to find and look at the next three or four verses and try to identify, can you see a fa'il, can you see a mawsuf, can you see a mudafun ilay? Your job now is to practice and see these things in the text. Okay, through your Quran periods especially, trying to see it in the text all the time. And the more you do it, because the problem is not understanding the concept, the problem is application all the time. But the thing is, once you do application a few times, you'll start seeing a pattern. Because the Quran uses certain patterns of expressions. So you start seeing different patterns. Okay. But one of the most important ways of application is what? Is doing your homework. That's what homework is all about. It's about applying the learning. So let's take out your homework, inshallah. Let's take out your homework. Your homework was 9.1. Your homework, right? 9.1 was homework, right? Yes. So let's go over some of that. Hopefully you have some writing on your page. No. So what is 9.1? 9.1, the focus there is Jumlatul Ismiyah, but it's Jumlatul Ismiyah with other stuff in it. You with me? It's not just two words, Al-Baytu Kabirun. It's Jumlatul Ismiyah with other elements added to it. So I think it's important for us to go through the answers one by one, inshallah. So we go to the first one. The first one says, Allah Alimun. Allahu Alimun, translation, Allah is all knowledgeable. So if you see Allahu Alimun, it's going to be a pattern. Because in the Quran, Allah is many things. Khabirun, Alimun, Basirun, Sami'un, Latifun, all these Asma al-Husna. So this is going to be like a pattern in the Quran. You understand what I say, a pattern? So you see it once now, then you see it number two, you see it twice now. And when you see the pattern, it's going to repeat all the time in the Quran. So what kind of pattern is this? This is a mubtada and a khabar. The focus of the sentence is Allah. The word Allah there is the focus of the sentence. It's the mubtada. It's a raf'un, it's definite. Because Allah is a proper noun. It's definite. So I'm starting with the word Allah, and what is the word alimun doing in the sentence? It's giving me news about Allah. Giving news about Allah is Allah Himself, because He's inconceivable. So how do you conceive the inconceivable? Is that the inconceivable must give you something to conceive. So it gives you some asma to sort of conceive Allah. But even the asma are infinite. And our understanding is always never perfect and never correct. Because our understanding is always based on analogy of what we know. And Allah is beyond all analogy. Allah is beyond all reference points. We only think in terms of reference points. Allah is beyond all of that. So Allah is giving us khabar about Himself. Allah Himself is saying, Allahu alimun, Allah is all knowledgeable. Allah, the word Allah is mubtada, the word alimun is khabar. Next one, Allahu ghafurun. Translation? Allah is all forgiving. Can you see the same construction? I'm starting with Allah is the focal sentence, mubtada, and I'm giving you khabar, and saying Allah is all forgiving. Next one, nicely, now we add something to make the sentence a bit longer. The thing we're adding, you should know already. Allahu alimun bil muttaqin. Translation? What's the first two words, Allahu alimun alone? Allah is all knowledgeable. But now in this ayah, something else added there. Bil muttaqin. Meaning what? With, be, by, with, regarding. Who? Al-Muttaqeen, the people of taqwa, the people of piety. Okay, so the translation, Allah is all knowledgeable about, regarding the people of taqwa, the people of piety. In terms of nahw, what we're saying there, the word Allah is still the focus of the sentence. It's a ism, it's raf, it's definite, starting the sentence. In other words, if you find mubtada khabar, that's how you find mubtada khabar. It's a ism, that's raf, that's definite. That's how you find it generally. All of them you can see, Allah, Qulubuna, As-Sulh, At-Talaqu, Al-Hajju, Al-Rijalu. We start in a sentence with an ism that is raf, that is definite. That's a general pattern for mubtada. Afterwards, we're following up with khabar, giving news. What about Allah? He is alimun, he is all knowledgeable. But now we're adding a what? A harful jar, bi. What comes after harful jar? Ismu majrur. And you can see muttaqeen there is jarrun. If that to be rafun, it will be what? Ina is jarun. What is raf'un? Muslimina. But raf'un is muslimuna. So muttaquna is going to be raf'un, and muttaqina is going to be nasbu jar, but we know it's jar. Okay, with me. So see, you're combining two concepts. You're combining your mubtada khabar plus your harful jar ism majrur. You can see, so you push the components together to make more and more detailed sentences. Next one, number four. Qulubuna ghulfun. What's qulub? Hearts. What's qulubuna? Our hearts. And what's ghulfun? Wrapped, covered. Doesn't mean a good thing, it means a bad thing. Because no? Not like a present is wrapped up like a present. It means it's covered and sealed and no light can go in. No light can go in. Qulubuna ghulf. So the translation there simply is our hearts are covered, our hearts are sealed, our hearts are wrapped. Okay. But what type of construction do we have? Tell me at first there, qulub, is that qulub, is it definite or indefinite, that qulubuna? Is it hearts, is it like specific hearts, or is it like different hearts, I mean indefinite hearts? Are some hearts wrapped, or is it a specific group of people? Qulubuna, specific group of people, a group of people that's saying our heart. I know it's definite, is because I remember I told you, is qulub ism a fi'l or harf? Hearts. Ism. What's the na doing there? The na is a damir, it's a pronoun. When you attach a pronoun to an ism, it's always mudaf, mudafun ilay. The hearts of us, our hearts. So the mudaf is always definite. Okay. Qulubuna is mudaf, mudaf nilay. At the same time, the word qulub is the mubtada. It's the focus of the sentence. Qulubuna is the focus of the sentence. Our hearts is the focus of the sentence. Give me khabar about our hearts. Khulfun. They are covered. Qulubuna khulf. So khulf is the khabar. So simple sentence. Qulubuna, qulub is the mubtada, and khulf is the khabar. At the same time, the na is the mudafun ilay for the word qulub. Because every damir attached to a ism is always mudafun ilay. Baytuhu, his house. Baytuka, your house. Baytuha, her house. Baytuna, our house. Qulubuna, our hearts. The hearts of us. Next one. As-sulhu khair. What's sulh? Reconciliation. Khairun is good or is better. Let's say as-sulhu, literally the reconciliation, khairun is better. So again, a simple sentence, mubtada khabar. What's the focus? As-sulhu. The reconciliation. What about the reconciliation? Khairun, it is a better path. It's a better path for people to reconcile the differences than to split up. You have as Ayah saying, As-sulh, to bring people together and reconcile, is khairun, is a better path to take than for people to just split up. As-sulhu khair. So the reconciliation, khairun, is better. Mubtara khabar. Next one. At-talaqu marratan. What's talaq? Divorce. At-talaq, the divorce. Marratani. What hal is marratani in? Muslimun, musliman, muslimin, muslimani. Muslimaini, muslimaini. Raf'un. Marratun, marratan, marratin, marratani. Put in nasbun. Marrataini jarrun. Marrataini. So you see, if you see ani, you know it's raf'un. So marratani is raf'un. At-talaq is raf'un. What construction do we have there? We have a mubtada and a khabar. A mubtada and a khabar. At-talaq, give me information about at-talaq. It is marratani, it is twice. The divorce is twice. Obviously the context of the ayah means the revocable divorce is twice. The third one comes, it's irrevocable. You understand? Okay. Now those are the first two, the marratan means the first two you can take your wife back, the third one you can't take your wife back. Okay, so that's the context of the ayah. Next one. Al-Hajj ashhurum ma'lumat. Al-Hajj, what Al-Hajj? The pilgrimage is ash, what's ashhur? Months. The pilgrimage is months. What months? Ma'lumat is what? Well-known months. So again, the focus of the sentence is Al-Hajj. What's the khabar about Hajj? It is months. Literally meaning what obviously takes place in months. But literally it means it is months. What is ma'luma doing in the sentence? It's describing what? The months. Which months? The well-known months. Al-Hajj is in the well-known months. Yeah. So Al-Hajj is the mubtada. Ashur is the khabar, and ma'lumat is the sifa for the mawsuf, which is ashur. So all we're doing is we bring two things together. We're giving mubtada and khabar together. There's mubtada and khabar is one thing, and we bring a sifa mawsuf. Okay. Next one. Ar-rijalu qawwamuna. You have an answer sheet for this, if you want to check the answer sheet, inshallah. Ar-rijalu qawwamuna ala nisa. Ar-rijal. What's ar-rijal? The men. The men. Which hal is it in? Rafun. Ar-rijal single, dual or plural? Plural. Broken plural because the single is rajul. Ar-rijal is the men. Qawwamun is what? Qawwamun is say maintainers, protectors. Long discussion about what qawwamun actually means. But say maintainers. Qawwamun is what? Single, dual or plural? Plural. Qawwamun, what had is it in? Raf'un. So we have raf' and raf'un. The one is definite, the one is indefinite. So what do we have? Mubtada, khabar. Ar-rijal is the focus of the sentence, the men. Give me news about the men. They are qawwamun. They are maintainers, protectors, guardians. Qawwamun, they are protectors, guardians, and all those things. But now Allah adds another thing. Ala nisa. Ala, upon, over, an-nisa, the women. So what's the ala there? Harfu jar, and after harfu jar comes what? Ismul Majrur. Translation: Ar-Rijal, the men, are Qawwamun, are protectors, maintainers, ala Nisa, over upon the women. So again, we add here, we have Mubtara Khabr, and we add what? Harfu Jar, Ismul Majrur. Again, what I'm looking for you in your own mind is not to be asleep and to say, okay, yes, yes, yes. I want you to be aware of the concepts coming out all the time. Because the more you are aware, you're going to see it all the time. There's a reason we chose only these concepts for first year. The reason we chose only these concepts for first year is these concepts appear all the time. So I want you to see it all the time. No. Next one. Aktharuhum fasiqun. Aktharuhum. Most of them are fasiqun. Let's say fasiqun, sinners. Aktharuhum. Aktharuhum means most. Whom? Them. Most them. It's actually mudaf in lay. The most of them. Most of them. Fasiqun are sinners. Again, aktharuh is the mubtara, the focus of the sentence. Give me khabar about them. What about most of them? Fasiqun, they are sinners. And fasiqun is in which hal? Raf'un, how do you put nasbun? Fasiqina in jarun. Fasiqina, what type of plural is it? Fasiqun. If you remember a long time ago, we told you the three types of plural. There's a male plural, female plural, broken plural. Which one is this? Jam'un mudhakkarun salimun, the sound, male plural, which is the una ina plural. Muslimun, musliman, or fasiqun, fasiqan, fasiqin, fasiqani, fasiqaini, fasiqaini, fasiquna, fasiqina, fasiquna. It's a sound, male plural, it's in rafun. Aktharum fasiqun, most of them are sinners, mubtara, khabr. The whom obviously there is mudafun ilay, because any damir attached to ism is always mudafun ilay. Next one. Yadahu mabsutatani. Now, let's look carefully there. What's a yad? A hand. How do I say two hands? Yadani or yadaini? Yadani in raf'un and in jar nasb is yadaini. But now I drop the noon there. I don't have yadan. Yadanihu. I drop the noon. Why I drop the noon? Because it's light. Remember, we drop it on wind, we drop a noon. Because it's a mudaf and mudaf in ilay. But that yada, is it yada? Is it yada nas? Raf'un, nasbun, and jarun? Does it come from yadani or from yadaini? Yada comes from yadani. Therefore, it's going to be raf'un. Yadahu means his two hands. Or the two hands of him. His two hands or the two hands of him. Mabsutatani. Can you see the end there? Ani. What's ani? Two. Raf'un. Mabsutatani means to be open. His two hands are open. Are spread out. His two hands are spread out. Again there, you must look carefully, but that's actually yada is raf'un. Mabsutatani is raf'un. But they're both duals. That's why they don't look so familiar. But they're both duals. So raf'un, raf'un is mubtada khabar. Yadahu is the focus of the sentence. His two hands. Tell me something about his two hands. Mabsutatani, they are open. They are spread out. Now, are you all with me so far? Okay. If you did the next few examples, you should be confused. And if you didn't do the next few examples, then you won't be confused. Because you're not sure there's something to be confused about. Okay. Alhamdulillah. Alhamdu. You can say Alhamdu the praise, or let's say all praise. Why praise? We'll discuss another time, inshallah. All praise or the praise? What does Lillah mean? For Allah, to Allah. So translate the sentence for me. All praise is for Allah, all praise is to Allah. Is that a complete sentence? Does it convey? Can you say Alhamdulillah? Can you say all praise belongs to Allah, is for Allah? Yes. Okay. So why should you be confused about that one? Because something is what type of construction? It's normally mubtara khabar.
normally mubtada khabar. So just think of mubtada khabar. Alhamdu is the focus of the sentence, right? Alhamdu is the focus of the sentence, yeah. All praise. Give me news about all praise. What about all praise? Give me news. What about all praise? Lillahi, it belongs to Allah. But if I look at Lillahi, what do I see there? What's the li? Harfu jar, and the word Allah, lafu jar, Allah is there, what? Ismul majrur. So the li is harfu jar, and the Allah is ismul majrur. So in other words, what am I looking for here? I can't find something here. I can't find the khabar. You with me? I can't find the khabar. I can find the mubtada, which is the focus of the sentence, but I can't find the khabar. Okay. So to make it easy, not to make it easy, in Arabic, sometimes a harfu jar and ism majrur can take the place of the khabar. So that lillahi is a li is a harfu jar still, and the word Allah is still an ism majrur, but that harfu jar and ism majrur takes the place of a khabar. For example, I say, the man is in the house. Is that a sentence? The man is in the house, a sentence? In Arabic it will be Ar-Rajulu Fil Bayti. Can you see it's different from saying Ar-Rajulu Tawilun, the man is tall, that's one thing, yes. But I say Ar-Rajulu Fil Bayti, am I still giving you news about the man? Yes, but the form of the news is going to be in Harfu Jar Ism Majrur. Okay, so it's a bit more advanced thing, but I'm just going to start highlighting to you because it comes very often in the Quran. Is that, I'll repeat it again. Is that sometimes, not sometimes, actually very often, a harfu jar and ism majrur takes the place of the khabar. It takes the place of the khabar. Now, if you're a nahu purist, you might have learned differently, but I just give you the simplified version of the pure version. Because the nahu purist will tell you that a harfu jar and ism majrur is attached to a khabar that is hidden, that you can't see. But I'll just leave it out, all that thing, and just say the harfu jar ism majrur is in place of the khabar. Next sentence. So in other words, what do I have there? Alhamdu, all praise is for Allah, belongs to Allah. Next one. As-sadaqatu lil-fuqara. As-sadaqat is what? The charity. What about the charity? Lil-fuqara, li, for, what's fuqara? The poor. Li harfu jar al fuqara, the poor, ism majrur. So translate the sentence for me. As sadaqat is the mubtada, it's the focus of the sentence. As sadaqat is the mubtada, the focus of the sentence. So lil fuqara is what? A harfu jar ism majrur, but takes the place of what? Takes the place of the khabar. Same as the previous one. Can you see that that's a complete sentence? As-sadaqat, the charity, give news about it. It is who, for the rich? No, not for the rich. Lil-fuqara, for the poor. So I have a mubtada, which is sadaqat, and the khabr here is in the form of a harful jar and ismul majrur. Very common in the Quran. Next one. You can see it again now again. Al-zalimuna fi dalalim mubin. Now it's getting longer and longer. What's al-zalimuna? Let's translate first. The wrongdoers, the oppressors. The wrongdoers, the oppressors. Al-Dhalim. What hal is al-Dhalimuna in? Raf'un. It's Raf'un, right? Translate the rest of the sentence. What about the Al-Dhalimun? Fi. They are in. Dalal. What's Dalal? Error or lost or astray. They are in error or lost, astray. What's Mubin? Clear. What is clear describing? It's describing a sifa for talal, for the astrayness, the lostness, how in clear error they are. Whatever error they're in, they're in a clear error. Translation, al-dhalimuna, the wrongdoers fi are in dalal, are in error, mubin, what type of error? In clear error. Let's do the back three words of the sentence. What's the fi? Harfu jar. What's the name of the harfu jar? Ism majrur. Dalalin is ism majrur because of the harfu jar. What's mubin doing? Sifa, what's it describing? Tala, which is also the masuf. Okay. Let's go back to your sentence at the beginning. Al-Dhalimuna is actually what? Mubtada. Al-Dhalimuna is Mubtada. Mubtada. What can you tell me about Al-Dhalimuna Mubtada? We can put it on the slide, eh? It's on the slide, eh? Yeah. Al-Dhalimuna is what? Is the focus of the sentence. Give me news about the focus of the sentence. What about the wrongdoers? Are they in Kirstenbosch? No. Where are they? Fi dhalalin mubin. Where are they? Al-dhalimuna is the focus of the sentence. Give me news about it. They are in dhalal. They are in error. Mubin. They are in clear error. Can you see the whole fi dhalalin mubin is a harfu isma jarur with a sifa. That whole thing takes the place of what? Khabar. Because the whole thing is giving you news about the al-dhalimun. Okay, so the whole thing there takes the place of a khabar. You alright so far? Inshallah. Can we confuse you more? Yes, bismillah, inshallah. What I'm saying, you should have been confused with this homework. Anyway. وَالْمَلَائِكَةُ يَدْخُلُونَ عَلَيْهِمْ وَالْمَلَائِكَةُ is what? And the angels. يَدْخُلُونَ عَلَيْهِمْ What's يَدْخُلُ? Entering, they are entering. يَدْخُلُ, يَدْخُلُونَ. And the angels are entering عَلَيْهِمْ upon them. Translation? And the angels are entering upon them. Okay. You ready for this? Take a deep breath. Ready for this? Okay. Because now I'm going to tell you something and be like, what's going on now? دَخَلَ يَدْخُلُوا يَدْخُلُونَ Ism fi'lu harf. Fi'l. Where's the fa'il for the yadkhuluna? In, left to in. Can't be right, can't be malaika, remember? In, left to in. In, that una. Una. They are entering. Alayhim. They are entering upon them. What did I say? When do you have jumlatul fi'liya? When you have a verb, you have jumlatul fi'liya. This part here, yadkhuluna alayhim. This part here. They are entering upon them. This little part here is a jumlatul fi'liya. The yadkhuluna alayhim, that part there is a jumlatul fi'liya. You can say it on its own. You can put it on its own. They are entering upon them. You with me? Okay. You with me so far? But what does the sentence start with? Now, ism, it is raf, that is definite. What's it normally? In all the examples, same thing, yeah? It's always an ism, it's raf, that's definite. What's it normally? Mubtada. Mubtada. Okay, so let's not take a step back quickly. Let's say that malaika is mubtada, right? The angels, and the angels, the angels. What is the news about the angels? What's the news about the angels? That they are entering upon them. So people go to Jannah and all the angels enter upon them. So the news about the angels is what? They are entering upon them. Ready for it? You ready for it? That jumlatul fi'liya takes the place of the khabr. I'll give an English example. Simple example. The man is tall. The man, give me news about him, is tall. That's a normal mutar khabar. Next one. The man is in the house. Give me news about the man. Is in the house. But another khabar takes a different form. Harfu jar ism majrur. The man is running. Give me news about the man. Is running. But running is what? Is a verb. So the verb is giving me news. Same thing here. The verb is just giving you news about the subject. So what do I call this here? I call this a jumlatul ismiyah. as jumlatul ismiyah wa malaikatu yadkhuluna alayhim, and I say that yadkhuluna alayhim, that's jumlatul fi'liyah. This whole thing is called jumlatul ismiyah, but that small part there, yadkhuluna alayhim, is jumlatul fi'liyah, and that jumlatul fi'liyah takes the place of the khabar. Yes. All that thing. There's no actual maf'ul, yeah? No maf'ul, but it can be a maf'ul bih. I'll give you an English example to make it easier. The man hit the boy. The man hit the boy. Now I'm saying it in Arabic now. Ar-rajulu, the man, daraba al-walada. Ar-rajulu, the man, daraba al-walada. Daraba al-walada is a jumlatul fi'liyah. The fa'il is inside there. It's a huwa. The maf'ul bihi is there. It's all there. Full jumlatul fi'liyah. That whole jumlatul fi'liyah is news about the man. Okay. Clear, like percolate a bit. Did it settle in? Marinade? No. Normally I teach only second year. I don't teach the first year normally. But you, mashallah. You're the best class this year. Mashallah. Okay, good. So the wa at the beginning might confuse you. In Arabic, there's four types of wa. So don't worry about the wa now. Okay, there's four types of wa. You know two of it. You know one wa means and you know one wa means by. Wallahi doesn't mean and Allah means by Allah. There's two more types. Okay. But to make it the answer question, you can have a sentence after an and. Don't think of English grammar now. You can have a jumlatul ismiya after and. I can say al waladu tawilun wa al bintu saghiratun. That's mubtara khabar and mubtara khabar. Be with me. Don't think of English now. English different language. No. Just briefly, quickly, what did I just say? So what did all of that I just said now? What I said in summary was that sometimes a verbal sentence can give you news about the mubtara. And the verbal sentence will be the khabar. Next one, same thing. Wal malaikatu yashhaduna. What's wal malaika? And the angels, what's yashhaduna? To make shahada, to be a witness, to testify, to be a witness. So what's the meaning of yashhaduna on its own? They are bearing witness. Is that a sentence? Yashhaduna, they are bearing witness, is a sentence. But that sentence is referring to who? Wal malaikatu. I'm starting here with an ism that is raf, that is definite. Can you see that ism that's raf, that's definite, is a mubtada. And what am I doing? I'm giving you news. What form is the news taking? In an ism or a fi'l form? A fi'l form, in a jumlatul fi'liyah form. So that yashaduna, they have a fi'l and a fa'il. They are bearing witness. That is in place of the khabar for the jumlatul ismiyah. Therefore, there's no other sentences. There's only ismiyah and fi'liyah. Because ismiyah can do a lot with it as well. You can do a lot with the ismiyah. Okay. Even if you're not 100% with me, just try to stay somewhat with me. Okay. Just stay somewhat with me on this, inshallah. Okay. So that finishes a new concept, just like slipped in there quickly. What is the new concept? That sometimes the khabar isn't just one word like ar-rajulu tawilun, Allahu alimun, Allahu basirun. Sometimes the khabar has different form. It can be in the house, harfu jar ism majrur. Or it can be a verbal sentence. Is running, went to the shop, yashaduna, are bearing witness. Sometimes the khabar can take a different form. Okay, that's all we're covering today. Next one. Hum kuffarun. Translation? They are disbelievers. Is that the sentence? Yes. What type of word is hum? It's a damir. They say all damirs all together huwa, bismillah. هو هم هي هن أنت أنتم أنت أنتن أنا نحن. Who means they? They are kuffar. There's actually a nominal جملة الإسمية. They are disbelievers. The whom is what? مبتدأ. And the given news about them, kuffar خبر. But remember, whom is one of those words you can't see the hal. It's what you call mabniyun. It's fixed. You can't see the hal. But it's going to be in rafun because it's the mubtada. Next one, ana abidun. Translation: I am a abid. I am a worshipper. Abid is a worshipper. I am a worshipper. Ana is the mubtada, the focus of the sentence, giving news about I. Abidun khabar. I am a worshipper. Next one. Oh, next one. Sure. I think it's a time to stop. So, 18, 19, 20. I think I gave you enough new things today. 18, 19, 20 is going to make you a complete demaka. So, I'll leave it for next week, inshallah. Those of you are brave. Not next week. Next week, unfortunately, there's no class. You should be sad about it. I don't know why you're smiling so much. You should, you know, heart feel deprived. Yeah, you should maybe toy toy or something, I don't know. But next week is school holiday, so we give you 1 week off. Only 1 week off, because next week is school holiday starts. But the following week is class again, so only give you 1 week off. So you don't have to drop out, just 1 week, take a rest. You can have some consistency for a change. So next week there's no class, and then the following week there is class. You also have homework for the following week. By the way, your homework is going to be 9. Your homework is 9.2. Again, the homework is what? Not only translation. Try to add the labels. فاعل مفعول صفة موصوف مضاف مضاف إليه حرف اسم مجرور اسم إشارة مشار إليه. Add the labels on your homework if you can. Your other piece of homework is mark 9.1. I marked now with you, but I gave you answer sheet as well. Go over it. Application is super important. What else is there? That's your homework, inshallah. And then that next lesson, we have our last lesson, which is 9.3, which we'll do in class, inshallah. And that will be the end of the Nahu workbook, inshallah. Good. Exciting? I'm excited. No. Just some admin announcements. So next week, no class. The following week, we have class. Then also, we want to, every year, we produce... You know, we have our registrations opening up soon, the next few weeks. So we generally like to interview students to just speak about the experience. So we want to ask you to volunteer to be interviewed. So we're going to ask you, if you're willing, inshallah, we're going to ask you, you can answer any one of the questions. Some of the questions can be, what is your favorite name of Allah and why? If you have an attachment to Al-Latif or Al-Wadud or Al-Rahman or Al-Malik or something, if you have a favorite name of Allah that you want to share, I want to ask you, what is your favorite name of Allah and why? That's one question you could answer, but on camera we'll film you nicely, inshallah. You look nice also, make the light right, and you put a nice tuki also, and nice top also, and come, inshallah. Or you can answer the question, what is your favorite surah or why? Or you can answer the question, what is your favorite verse or why? Or you can answer the question, what is your favorite story in the Quran or why? We just want actually people to speak about the experience of the Quran. Obviously, you're still a bit new because you just started off the Quran, but I'm sure you have some attachment to something, inshallah. So that's what we're going to ask. Or you can just ask a general question about how the Quran has impacted your life. And it could also be maybe not your life here in Sunday class, could be even be your wife who's at another Darul Zahra, Darul Naeem, or your child who's been there, your daughter, mashallah, is going, you can feel the change. Just to speak about how the Quran has impacted your life. So whoever's ready, inshallah, you can, brothers, you can give your name at the back there, inshallah. And then we'll film you, not next week, we'll film you the week after. We'll bring a filmmaker, photographer to come in, and then we'll interview you shortly. So you saw the videos last year. Last year we compiled videos and we put together. But I'm encouraging you, if you can, it's part of da'wah as well. It's part of calling people to study Quran, calling people towards Allah. So we're going to ask, and the sisters, inshallah, you can give your name to, Sister Nasreen, if you are willing, inshallah. And you're also going to be famous. You're going to be famous. Inshallah. Okay. Let's end with some nasiha. And then, brother, I remind you, and sisters, inshallah, that your camp is on the 2nd to the 4th of November. I must actually send the official email. But the 2nd to the 4th of November will be the brothers' camp. On the 4th of November will be the sisters' fragrance for the soul. It will be Sunday morning for the sisters, and the brothers will be from Friday after Asr, after Maghrib, until Sunday lunch, inshallah. We're going to give, obviously, as always, first preference to Mizan students, and after that we'll open it up if there are spaces available. There's also a sister who emailed me, I'm not sure if she's in class now. She wants to start a discussion group for schooling. So is she here? Who emailed me? Is the list here? Okay, okay, inshallah. So anyway, there's a sister who wants to start a discussion group for children her age, inshallah. We'll give you the list and you can sign up for the group. It's a separate thing from, it's a separate discussion, inshallah. And a few words of nasiha.